Hello everyone. Now our next experiment is based on exception handling in Java. Before going into detail of the exception handling, we have to understand what is meant by the exception. An exception is a condition that is caused by a runtime error in a program. In Java, an exception is an event that disrupts the normal flow of the program, that is disrupting all the flow of the program. So it is an object which is thrown at runtime. Now what is meant by the exception handling? Exception handling mechanism suggests the incorporation of a separate error handling code that performs the following tasks, like finding the program, means what is the problem in the program. Then inform if the problem is there, then inform what problem has occurred or what an error has occurred, that is throw the exception. Then third step is receives the error information, that is the catch exception. So if there is error is occurred, then we have to try to catch that error or exception. Then if the error is occurred, then you have to take the actions to correct that error or to handle that exception. So these are the four steps we have to perform, and all this task cumulatively you can say that the exception handling is there. So in other words, you can say that exception handling is a mechanism to handle the runtime errors like class not found exception, IO exception, SQL exception, remote exception, etc. Now the Java exception keywords are there because by using these five keywords you can handle the exceptions in your Java programs. So now what are those five keywords? So these five keywords are try, catch, throw, throws, and finally. So what is the meaning of the try keyword? Now let's see these five keywords one by one. The try keyword is used to specify a block where you can place the exception code. Means if there is error might occur, then that code you can put it into the try block. The try block must be followed by either the catch block or the finally. It means we can't use the try block alone. So in other words, we can say that the try block is followed by the catch or the finally. Okay, it cannot be used alone. Then the next keyword is the catch. The catch block is used to handle the exception. Means if there is an error occurred in the try block, then that error can be handled by the catch block. It must be preceded by the try block, which means that we can't use the catch block alone. It can be followed by finally block later. The finally block is used to execute the important code of the program, and it is executed whether an exception is handled or not. Then throw. The throw keyword is used to throw an exception manually. That is, in the program, if you want to throw an exception manually, then you can use the throw keyword. The throws keyword is used to declare the exceptions. That is, it doesn't throw an exception. Next, it specifies that there may occur an exception in the method. It is always used with the method signature. Now these are all information about the exception handling and the Java keywords used that are using in the exception handling program. Now see here the programs. So the first program is exception handling in Java. And in that program, the try catch block is used here. Okay, so there is the first class is there, exception handling class, and in that main method, I have used here try and catch block. So in the try block, I have defined the code. So first, there is a variable is declared here, data. The assigned value is 100, and that value is divided by the 0 here. So the error will be occurred, and that error is called as a arithmetic exception or arithmetic error because the value is not divided by the 0. Okay. Then there is a string x is equal to null. Means the null value is assigned to the x variable of the string type. And I'm printing here in the println statement the length of that string value to whom null value is assigned. So there will be error occurred or exception occurred, and that exception is called as a null pointer exception. Next, there is a string variable y and the value is assigned a string abc, and I'm trying here to convert that string into the integer and store the value into the integer I. So there will be also error occurred or exception occurred, and that exception is called as a number format exception. Next, there is a array A is defined and whose length is 5, and in the next statement the value 50 is assigned to the 10th index of the array A. So there will be the error occur because the length of the array is 5 and I am assigning the value 50 to the 10th index, which I am not defined here because the length is 5 only. So there will be the error occurred, and that error or exception is called as a array index out of bound exceptions. Now in the catch block, there are the catch block, and in that catch block I handle the exception of the occurred in the try block. So catch arithmetic exception E, in this catch block I am handle the try I handled here the exception, arithmetic exception in this catch block. In the next catch block I have handled here the null pointer exception. Next, in this third catch block, the number format exception E is handled here. And last catch is array index out of bound exception is handled here. Now see the output here. Now see here the output is displayed, that is java.lang.arithmeticexception divided by 0 here. Why this is this output window displays this message? Because in the try block there is a first statement is there, integer data is equal to 100 divided by 0. So this value is divided by the 0, so this error is occurred, and this error is handled by this catch block. So the error output is displayed, that is divided by 0 exception. But when I'm trying to executing the next statement, it will not execute, because if an exception occurs at a particular statement of the try block, then the rest of the code will not execute. Understood? So I have to here comment the statement, because if I am not doing this, and every time you run this program, then every time you see this only output, the other errors and other catch blocks will not execute, because once their error is occurred, because in the try block first time the error is occurred as divided by 0, so every time this statement will be executed, another statement will not execute. Understood? So I am commenting here to understand the rest of the code of our program. So there is a null, and this exception occurred is null pointer exception. So this will show in the output by running the program. Now see here, null pointer exception. So to show the another exceptions, so I am trying here commenting the program. Now again see the output. Okay, here the number format exception for input string ABC. Again I am commenting this. Now this see the output. So the output is array index out of bound exception. See here. Now understood here? Okay, the next exception handling program is the by using the throw keyword. Now see here in the program, there is a class test throw, and there is a method is validated, and the parameter is passed as the age whose stat is the integer. And there is one condition: if age is less than 18, then throw the new arithmetic exception and the message is not valid. Otherwise, else statement will be executed. So now you have to know what is meant by the throw keyword. The throw keyword is used to manually throw an exception. The throw keyword is used. So here in this if condition and if this in this if block, I'm trying to manually throwing an exception that is not valid. And there is a class exception throw here. In that main method is there. In the main method, the object of the test throw is created, and by using this object, the validate method is called here, and the parameter passed is the 20 here. Then if the parameter passed is 20, and now see here, if the parameter passed is 20, then 20 is less than 18. The condition is false, then else statement will be executed here. Welcome to OAT and normal flow. If now see here, the parameter passed is 20. If I change here, I will change here the 13. Okay, then the age will be 13 is less than 18. So this condition will be true, and this block will be executed. That is throw new exception that is not valid. So I am here manually throwing an exception by using the throw keyword. Now see here in the output window, okay, not valid. This is the error occurred, and that I am manually throw exception. Now our next experiment is based on the finally block. Now the finally block, why the finally block is used? The finally block is used to execute the important code of the program, such as closing the database connection and the stream. Okay, so there are the three cases in the finally: try, catch, finally. In this finally, there are the three cases are there. The first case is where the exception doesn't occur in the program. Then also you can use the try, catch, finally. At that time, finally block is executed always. The second condition is, or second case is, that where the exception occurs but not handled. At that case also, the finally block is always executed. Then the third condition is there in the program: if the exception is occurs and if that handled, then also the finally block is always executed. Means in three cases, always the finally block will be always executed. Understood? So now see here in the program, and I have used the third case, that is the exception will be occurred and also the handled by the catch block, and there is a finally block also. Now see here, there is a class exception finally, and in the main method there is a try block, and in the try block there is a variable data and the value 25 is divided by the 0. So there is an error occurred, that is exception occurred, that is arithmetic exception divided by 0 exception. So this exception is handled by the catch block, arithmetic exception E. And there is a next, there is a finally block, and the message is simple message is there, final block is always executed. And the last statement is the rest of the code. If there is a large number of applications, then there will be the rest of the code will be there. Okay. Now see the output here. The error is occurred, that is exception is occurred, divided by 0 exception, and the print message is finally block is always executed, and the rest of the code message is displayed here. Okay. Thank you.